know this isn't the only drought we're going to have in North Dakota. Droughts happen periodically. How can we increase our resilience to future droughts in our grazing systems? And one of the keys is we want to make sure that our stocking rate is set right and we're not exceeding the carrying capacity of that pasture. And so just monitoring and reevaluating that on a regular basis. And when we are in a drought situation, making early adjustments to that stocking rate so that we can make sure that we're not overgrazing and putting additional stress on those grazing resources. Also, if we can build resilience into our grazing system by implementing a rotational grazing system of some sort, so that builds recovery into that system, because we have multiple pastures, so we're not grazing one pasture for a whole season, and that allows pastures to rest. If you had a rotational grazing or have a rotational grazing system, as you prepare for 2022, don't start in the pastures that got overgrazed the heaviest this year. Give those a chance to recover. And so having a system like that helps us build recovery. Especially if you have a rest rotation system where one pasture isn't grazed every year, then that gives you a stockpile of forage that you can utilize. Another really good option that's becoming more popular in North Dakota is the utilization of annual forages into our system. And so behind us, we have some cows that are grazing a full season cover crop. That's one option. A lot of people don't want to go that option, but there's a lot of shorter season options. So planting a winter cereal such as a rye or triticale or a winter wheat that can be grazed in the spring and delay pasture turnout and give you a little more flexibility in your grazing system. Or we can do a fall cover crop that goes in after one of our earlier harvested crops. And that gives us just a little flexibility, some supplemental feed, forage, whether you graze it or hay it. That gives us a little extra wiggle room within our system as we're managing that. And any way we can increase that flexibility, it helps increase that resilience of that system. Other thing is take advantage of some of our water development programs and making sure you have good water in all of your pastures, and maybe even adding it to some of your cropland situations so that you can better utilize those for grazing annual forages. Right now, because of the drought, there have been several programs triggered that can help with cost share assistance. The State Department of Water Resources has assistance program, as well as some counties have assistance through their FSA through the Emergency Conservation Program. So contact your local FSA office and see what's available. Other options are just those more normal, traditional ones that are always around, such as the NRCS EQIP program, or some programs through some of our state agencies or non-government organizations such as Ducks Unlimited. So be aware of those different options that you can utilize to increase your resilience within your system and enhance your ability to get through droughts in the future.